Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the geography class 8 chapter number 3, that is the impact of migration on donor region. In the previous video we have talked about the important impact of migration, but by particularly means going to discuss the impact of migration or donor region, then after we will talk about the impact of migration on receiver region. Donor region are the region which send the immigrant to other countries. We send the people to other countries, and from the region people goes to another region. It's called donor region. There are the positive and negative effect both. What is the impact of positive effect? And what is the negative impact? Let's see. First of all, immigration reduces the population density. Means immigration reduces the population density, means people which go to the other countries, other states, by which the population density of the donor region reduced and help over the overpopulation. Help in over population means reduce the overpopulation. Okay, now this is the positive impact. Immigration reduces the birth rate, as migrants are mostly young adults who wishes to raise the family. Due to immigration, it reduced the birth rate, because migrant who are able to increase the young ones, which make the birth rate rich, that go to the other countries, so it reduce the birth rate. Next, migrants send back money. The people who has gone to the other countries send the money to their native places, so it increase. So it help the economic development. Okay, so they help the economic development. Now, what are the negative impact? The negative impact means due to the immigration, the loss of skill labor occur. And there is a loss of skill labor, so this slow down the economic development. When the skilled people go to the other countries, by which the skill labor reduce in the native places, so this slow down the economic development. Next one, immigration lead to loss of young people of working age. You know, when the working age means adult age go to the other countries, then what happen? Then the many people which are dependent on the working people has many problems, has difficulties. So it is a very difficult for the dependent people who are totally depend upon the working people. Now, immigration causes family structure to break down. Means it break down the family structure, because the generally the male goes to the other countries, but their family remain in the native places. So it break down the structure. Break down the structure of the family means the number of proportion of the people in or of men in decreases and the female increases. Next one, immigrants often give up their own culture. Means when the people goes to the another country, adopt the culture of the other country and leave the culture of the own country. So it is a very this became more and more evident over the generation. Means when the immigrant lost their culture, this happened more and more in new generation, and the totally culture changed of their families. Now the next topic is the impact of migration on the receiver region. Let's see. Now The next one is the impact of migration on receiver region. Means what is the impact? Let's see. Immigration reduces underpopulation. Means in the receiver region, the immigrants increase the population and reduce the underpopulation. Underpopulation means the population get more. Next one is, it increase the supply of labor. It increase the supply of labor in the receiver region, and all these help in the economic development. Economic development of the country, it helps. Next one, immigrants worker may be willing to work at cheaper rate. The immigrant people willing to work at the cheaper rate than the native workers. Next, immigration increases the working population and help in the more production in the industries. And next, the presence of people of different religion, races, languages and culture increase the understanding and tolerance among the different groups. These are the positive impact. The negative impact are the large scale immigration increases the pressure on the local resources. Large scale immigration increases the pressure on the local resources, especially in the already crowded cities, such as if a large number of houses are built in a small places, most people have to live in the small apartment. House rent and land price are very high, and those who can't afford housing live in the cities in very congested and unsanitary condition. Means due to the increase in the population, people have to live in a very small areas, in the large number of apartment is formed, so there are very congested and untidy. Next, sometimes industries prefer to employ cheap migrant labor. This makes it difficult for the local people to get job. Okay, now the large amount of money earned by the immigrants is sent back to their native places, so the economic condition, means economy of the receiver country, may be loose. Okay, now next one is, the large scale of immigration make immigration of the different language, religion, culture may lead to the conflict between the local people. Okay, now next topic is the brain drain. Let's see. The brain drain refers to the migration of the large number of highly skilled and educated people like doctors, scientists, advocates, etc. And it is technically called as the human capital flight. This is called as human capital flight because it is the main source of the income of the government and the countries. It is referred to the moving away the human resources from a region. Okay, now what are the causes of brain drain? Means there are the many causes of brain drain that pull the people to other countries, and that push the people to other country. The pull push factor are the low earning, lack of facilities, means the country is having the very low earning and there is a lack of facilities. Causes the brain drain. Okay. Poor condition of work, poor work culture, and the lack of freedom at the work. Now, the political and the economic instability also lead to the people to migrate in the other countries. What is the push factor? Pull factor. Means this is the push factor and this is the pull factor. Pull factors. Pull factors is just opposite to the push factor. That is the high earning. If there are high earning in the other country, other states, the people want to go there and settle there. Better job opportunities. And adequate facilities of education, training and the research, good condition of work, good work culture and the political and economic stability. These are the pull factor and these are the push factor that lead to people to migrate in the other countries. This is the brain drain, cause of brain drain. Now the next topic is the impact of brain drain. Next one is the impact of brain drain. What is the impact of brain drain? First of all, brain drain is a cause for the concern, cause of the concern, because it robs a country of its brightest people. It robs a country of its brightest people. Its impact is therefore generally seen as negative more, and it has a positive side as well. What are the negative impact? First of all, country loses skilled labor. Country loses skilled labor and slowing down the development. When the skilled people like doctors, scientists and good teachers go to the another country, it slow the development of the countries. Okay. The country loses the services of scientists, doctors and teachers that lead to the fall in the quality of the medical research and educational facilities. Okay. The country loses businessmen and its economy suffers. The resources that country has spent on the education and the training, the immigrants are wasted. Means the people who immigrant to the other countries and the countries that have spent to earn goes to waste, because they go to the other country and they develop the other countries. The country loses the taxes that immigrant would pay. Means whatever the country have to gain the taxes from the people that are the immigrants, that losses. Immigration of some and their succeed abroad encourages other to follow. What are the positive impact? The positive impact, those who immigrants sharpen their skills, means the people who go to the abroad, they sharpen their skills, and when they ever come to the native countries, improve the quality of the education, research and the training. Those who immigrant send back a large part of their resource income. Means the people who go to the other country, they send back the large part of their income to their native country and increase the development, help in the development of the countries. Next, the immigrants encourage the people to go get good education, training, and develop the skills. This was the impact of the brain drain. And now this is the last topic of the chapter 3. We will discuss the new chapter of the second term, that is the urbanization, in the next video.